It's the end of summer, but that doesn't mean it's too late for summer polishes, does it? Hi guys, it's Crystal, and today we're swatching the Summer 2018 Ultra Holographics from ILMP. I got these really early in the summer, right when they released. I actually ordered on the pre-order, but I did not get around to swatching them until now. To start off, we have Kiss and Tell. I chose this because it's one of my top two colors in this collection. It's definitely a favorite. I mean, the top two kind of tie for favorites, but this is a very beautiful, bright flamingo pink ultra holographic. This is stunning, and I want to combine it with some of the others in the collection to do some nail art. I just haven't gotten to it yet. I did use several other colors in a nail art look recently, which I'll actually link at some point. I think I'll link it at the end of the video, and I'll probably link it as a little thing up in the corner that you can click on about now when I'm talking about it. But I haven't gotten around to using this one yet. This applies really super smooth. It goes on in two easy coats. I thought a few of these were going to take three coats, which I don't mind having to do three coats. It's when you go past three coats that I'm like, eh, not loving it. But they didn't. They actually went on in two coats, complete coverage, even under my really, really bright lights, and they were flawless. This one is so pretty, and that holo shines through and makes it pop, which I love. See? So much pretty. If I could, I'd have probably put in like 8 pictures of that and just none of the others. But I had to include photos of all of them. Next up, we have Tidal Wave. This is a very, very gorgeous cornflower blue. This is stunning. This is not one of my top two, but it does kind of make, you know, top three maybe. Actually, I can't say it's top three. I just thought of another color that would be top three. You know, it's so hard to pick favorites with these because linear hollows are my weakness, and the ultra hollows from ILMP have always been ultra weaknesses. I can't help it. This one goes on really deceptively sheer. Not gonna lie, you can see it here. But in the second coat, it actually built up and I had full coverage from it, which I'm not mad at, okay? I already said I don't like going past three coats, but I wouldn't mind three coats, honestly. The Ultra Holographics from ILMP, though, I've learned, none of them I think I've ever used has needed three coats. I've always expected some of them to, but they really haven't. I'm waiting for Barb to put out like a bright yellow or something that ends up taking three or four coats, and then I'll have to eat my words. But until then, I mean, we're good. It's good. Next in our Ultra Holo Parade, we have Pick Me Up. This is an orchid purple ultra holographic. This is so super pretty. This is actually one of the other colors that I mentioned earlier I'd used in some nail art previously. Wow, my voice just cracked really badly there. Holy sorry guys. Anyways, I used this in some nail art previously. I used it in this really cute zebra look. And I will have that linked at the end of this video, and it's probably been linked before this in the corner. Either way, this is super stunning. Once again, a two-coater, but look at that coverage in one coat. That was pretty sick looking, okay? I gotta tell you, in one coat, this thing was pretty hot. I almost thought this would be a one-coater, but then I shined a light up under my nail, which is my real test to see if it shows through. And it showed through with the light under my nail, so I went in for the second coat. This is super gorgeous, and purple is definitely a weakness, so this is one of my top three. This is the third in my top three. The other one that is in the top three is actually another purple. Next up, we have Sail Away. This is so beautiful. This is a bright turquoise, and I don't know what to say. I love turquoise colors, but I usually don't like turquoise hollows as much. I don't know what it is. Great turquoise cream, I'm down. Turquoise shimmer, yeah. Hollows, never been a fave. I don't know what it is about them. I think it's because they usually have like a green inner glow that kind of puts me off. But I'm not mad at this one. It doesn't have a weird inner glow. It doesn't have a shimmer that like offsets the turquoise hollow. It's just straight, beautiful, bright turquoise hollow, and it actually like reminds me of pictures of Greece and the oceans I've seen there. I'd like to go there one day, but that's just not happening right now. But it is so super beautiful. This is definitely gonna be a summer fave for me. I'll probably wear this deep into fall, okay? If you've been around this channel long enough, you know that the bright colors stick around all year. Next, we have Sundance. This is a very bright, in-your-face lemon lime green. Okay, I can't help it. It is just so bright and beautiful. In the bottle, I actually thought that this was going to take 3 to 4 coats. This is the one that I was talking about. It was really like, I was like, okay, this is going to need buildup. But it only took 2 again, and I was super excited for that. In fact, you can see as it's going on here, the coverage is insane. I also thought this would have like a really, really yellow glow to it, and it didn't. I thought it was gonna, and when I first took photos, I was seeing in the viewfinder, I thought there was a yellow shimmer coming off of it. But then when I looked at them and when I cropped them to put in this video, I realized, no, this is just straight lemon lime green. And I keep calling it lemon lime. I guess I should just call it lime green, but I always call lime lemon lime. But it's just a straight, bright, gorgeous green, and I love it. Even though I don't love greens that much, I love that one. Last but certainly not least, we have Sidekick. This is a very beautiful, bright purple ultra holographic. This is one of the top 3 as well. This is number 2 in my, you know, top 3. Because it is stunning. I cannot help it. This purple is like a bright, perfect purple. This is the purple of my dreams. I wish I had like this shade just slightly darker and slightly lighter so I could make a gorgeous triple gradient with all of them. It would be just like the most flawless purple gradient ever. This went on in 2 coats. I did think this was gonna take more than 2. It did not though. It was actually super gorgeous. I feel like I said, I think 3 out of the 6 I thought were gonna take more than 2 coats and they didn't. So I'm not mad at them. I actually love this entire collection. I didn't expect to. When I first saw swatches on the website and I saw the bottle shots, I didn't think I was gonna like the green on my nails. And I honestly didn't think I was gonna like the pink as much as I ended up liking it, but I did. So I'm not regretting grabbing this collection at all. As always, I'm going to have everything linked in the description box that I used here, as well as a link to the blog if you like to see more photos and the macros and stuff. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a big thumbs up and hit the subscribe button for more fun stuff and tutorials. And I will see you guys next time.